I was talking about the multivibrator in my earlier video, and we gonna study it better. So I have found my gum, and perhaps it's interesting to show again part two. My camera stopped suddenly during, after say quarter of an hour. Gum it out again. Perhaps it's more interesting to show it how it's really made. This stays intact, and this is again about the Darlington coil. I've showed the coils. AC out. Here is the Darlington. So you can directly wire your Darlington into this circuit. Collector, emitter, emitter, base. Yes, so the base. And now the backcoupling capacitor is connected here to the collector. So now it's directly wired in, and we have a situation where we can drive a power transistor, power high voltage transistor, or another power transistor, and we have a good high voltage out. And what I told earlier, that's very important for such a transformer, a real high voltage transformer. Say this transformer is made for 16 kilohertz. It has a ferrite core. Try to get the whole circuit to 16 kilohertz, and that can be done by finding out the right capacitor value for such a high frequency. It is approximately in the 4.7 nanofarad range. And also important to tell, this transistor must be cooled in that case, otherwise it gets too hot. This of course will draw a substantial current. Say it can be 1 ampere. And so that's an important adaptation. Well, that was more or less all to tell. And I've told that when you this gives an RC time. This is a time dependent unit. In fact, the whole combination is time dependent, and that tells us why a change of the voltage gives a change in the frequency. Okay. But there is another way to make the frequency really changeable, and that's also in that book, Television. I have to find the page. I hope I can find it now. I wasn't very quick in the first video, but this is the principal circuit with tubes. That was the last stage of the first video. The voltage to the grid is changed. That means that the frequency changes. And the transistor variant is here. Now we have to change the voltage to the base. You can also do that without a Darlington. So let's do it. Make a circuit with which we can change the voltage to the base. That's very, very simple, because we know we have here 12 volts. Opposite to ground. And we, a voltage divider gives us the right circuit to make a changing voltage. And this voltage divider is made with a 3K resistor. That's a protective resistor. I will tell more about it later. A potentiometer of say 100K. And now we connect this. Now we know when we change that voltage on the wiper, we move the wiper up and down, it gets more positive and it gets negative when we move the wiper down. So here we have a changing voltage between say this is 18 volts, and then we have approximately half of the voltage, and here we, this is completely to the negative, so we have a negative voltage here. But anyway, the idea was to change the voltage on the base of the multivibrator. So connect it to the first base and connect it, oops, to the second base. When we now turn the wiper, the voltage changes on the base of these two transistors, and the frequency will change substantially. By the way, the same circuit. Let's see whether that's true. I've made this circuit, but now I've made it not with a Darlington, but with a normal transistor. So, take some time, sorry for that. Transistor. Here again 1K. Here output cap 100 nanofarad to the minus. The capacitor in this demonstration video is 100 nanofarad. Yes, this one is connected here, and this one also goes to the base. Did I do it right? Yes. So, to both bases of the transistor, we now can set a certain positive voltage, or it moves from positive to negative. That means that we can change the frequency. So this is in fact the same circuit. Here we change the frequency, sorry, the voltage to both emitters, sorry, to both base connected. And that's what I've made here. And you can see that potentiometer, the 3K3 resistor, the two transistors, the 100 and nano capacitor, the output cap, the yellow one. And let's see what happens when we turn the potentiometer, and that means we change the voltage to the base of both transistors. My camera is in the zoom mode, so it's quite different, difficult for me. Change the voltage. We see a complete change of waveform. And it interferes with my camera, but anyway, it doesn't matter. And we can also see that the frequency changes. 887, say 880 hertz, and we change the working point going back to the lowest frequency that it can give,
that's approximately 100 hertz. 100 hertz. Six, six, 9 hertz, and this is the highest frequency. So,
a circuit that's analog to the circuit out of the book Television. And of course, in this case, you can also use again here the Darlington instead of one transistor. So, replace this by this circuit. It also has a B. Oh, sorry, I forgot to draw this wire, otherwise it will not work. But that's clear out of the preceding video. Always one capacitor collector to base, one capacitor back collector to base, and then you can change the frequency. And of course you can use here, instead of that one transistor, the Darlington with one power transistor and another transistor. Good transistors for high voltage circuits are transistors that have a good collector, high collector emitter voltage, but also a high collector base voltage. And that's very important, because a transistor, the driver transistor especially, can be get easily damaged by a too high base voltage. And the BD139 has the good property that the collector base voltage is 80 volts and the collector emitter voltage is somewhat higher, perhaps also 80 volts. But especially the base of these circuits, of these transistors, is very sensitive, can be easily damaged by a too high voltage on its base and a too high current. And especially when this circuit oscillates on a certain frequency, there are quite unpredictable voltages in the circuit. And one idea could be to prevent that. Say we have the Darlington here. So, Darlington. Here is the coil. Say it's 18 volts. Emitter. Now, there is always the story, but I never got it very well confirmed, that a diode can help. So it can help to protect the transistor against too high inductive pulses. Of course, could be that it works. I don't have so much experience with that. Sometimes I use such a diode, but there's also another more simple way to protect your transistor, and that is to connect a resistor parallel to that coil. That resistor will damp out the highest voltages. This must be done experimental. Of course, make the resistor not so low that the coil is shortcut. You can take, for instance, 100k. Try it with 100k. Or with 1 mega ohm. 1 mega ohm is a very high value. Perhaps it will not have any damping effect on the voltage here. But anyway, one thing that I forgot to tell in that first video is this. Here we drive that Darlington via a capacitor. But sometimes it works much better to drive the Darlington via a resistor. So you can send somewhat more current in. Somewhat more current. I have to make some corrections, take some time, sorry. Say it's 16 kilohertz. Here's also a flaw. Oh no, this is good. This is the cap, this is one cap, so it will work. You can drive that in via a resistor. And good values are between 3k and 100k. That depends, of course, on the used type of transistor, but these are in general good values. And in that case, it could be that you don't need that specific voltage divider to set the working point of that transistor. This all, of course, when you are doing these experiments, everything must constantly be controlled with the oscilloscope. So when you drive a high voltage transistor, could be that this works much better. And forget that circuit with that potentiometer. And to set a working point. Because the reason is that the transistor receives, in that case, both a positive voltage here on its base, a DC voltage, so it is set to a certain working point, because we have here a 1K resistor and here a series resistor. So it receives a positive voltage, and at the same time, superposed on that voltage, on that DC voltage, there is that high frequent square wave signal. So that's also important. And of course you can use here also the Darlington. Positive generator. Negative 12 to 18 volts. It receives its DC here together with the AC. So sometimes this can also help, but of course it's better to not to give it an extra DC voltage on its base. So collector, emitter, base, collector, emitter, base, Darlington. So that was more or less all to tell about that circuit. Very interesting, very versatile. Forgot to tell that you can also go with this circuit to very low frequencies. In that case,